Hello children, welcome back. In the last session, we have completely understood about the magnetism that will be exhibited by the bar magnets. And today, we are going to understand the very important and small subtopic of this magnetism, that is the magnetic materials. And let us know first, what is the origin of magnetism that will be shown by the materials. So first of all, the Curie and Faraday, they have first discovered that all the materials in this universe will have a certain amount of magnetic property. Their magnetic response will come from the orbital and spin motion of an electrons. So we know very well, around in the orbital, around the nucleus, electrons will be move around. And this orbital motion of electron will constitute some magnetic moment perpendicular to the plane contained in the orbital. And as well as this orbital motion, along with this orbital motion, the spin motion of an electron will also constitute some magnetic moment. For an atom, if I want to speak about the magnetic moment, that is nothing but the vector sum of the total magnetic moment of the orbital motion magnetic moment and the spin motion magnetic moment. So for an whole substance, the magnetic moment may be become zero or may not be becomes zero. So based on this context, we can divide the materials, we can divide the magnetic materials like dia, para and ferro. Before going to understand about this classification further, we have to speak about certain important terms. They are, the first one is magnetic induction. What is the meaning of magnetic induction? This magnetic induction is nothing but the total number of magnetic induction, which is denoted by the letter P. This magnetic induction is nothing but the total number of magnetic lines of force crossing any area normally through the specimen. So let us suppose here I have one specimen. I don't know what kind of material it is. It is a one specimen that is immersed in a uniform magnetic field. Then what will happen? Certain number of magnetic lines of force will go through the material that will be originated from the magnetism of the specimen. So this is an external field. And there will be certain magnetic field which will be generated within the specimen also. So there will be certain number of lines which are going through the specimen too. Hence, the total number of magnetic lines of force crossing any area normally will be called as a magnetic induction. And this magnetic induction will have the unit of Weber per meter square. Weber per meter square. It is the unit for magnetic induction. And the next one we need to know is the magnetizing field intensity. Magnetizing field intensity. What is the meaning of this one? So it will be denoted by the letter H. So it is the actually the magnetizing field intensity is nothing but the characteristic of the external field in which we have kept the specimen of any magnetic material. So if it is strong enough to make it the specimen to have some magnetism, then it is said to be have a more intensity. Simply calling magnetizing field intensity is nothing but property of a external magnetic field. And it have some relation with the magnetic induction. What is that is? Usually we will write like this. B equals to mu naught into H. Mu naught equals to mu naught into H, or B equals to mu into H. What is the meaning of this? B naught is nothing but the magnetizing field, magnetic induction that will be arises when there is no specimen. So if this is a uniform magnetic field, so let me assume there is a one small volume. There is a one small volume, just like this specimen, I am assuming one small volume. Then definitely certain number of magnetic field lines will go through that assumed volume. So that is nothing but magnetic induction. The total number of magnetic lines of force that crossing through the assumed volume will be called as a magnetic induction. That magnetic induction must be equals to mu naught times of H, the magnetic permeability of the free space multiplied by the magnetizing field intensity. And from here, B equals to mu into H. When this will be formula, when this formula will be applicable, when I keep the specimen like this here, then there will be certain magnetic induction caused here. And that B must be equals to mu times of H. So therefore, the H will have a two formula, B naught by mu naught, or H equals to B by mu. Simply calling the ratio of magnetic induction to magnetic permeability. the ratio of magnetic induction to magnetic permeability caused inside the substance, magnetic substance, that will be called as a magnetizing field intensity, and for it unit could be called as a ampere per meter. For it the unit is nothing but ampere per meter, and hence, and let us move for the next small subtopic, and that is the next term we need to understand, the intensity of magnetization. The third one we need to understand, intensity of magnetization. What is the intensity of magnetization? Intensity of magnetization is a basically vector quantity, and which is defined as the total magnetic moment developed per unit volume. The direction of intensity of magnetization and the direction of a magnetic moment that developed inside the specimen will be in the same direction. So, I equals to M by B. We know very well the magnetic moment will be measured with a unit called ampere into meter square divided by the volume is nothing but meter cube. Therefore, what is the unit of intensity of magnetization? Ampere per meter. This is the unit of intensity of magnetization. And the fourth one we need to understand is nothing but magnetic susceptibility. Magnetic susceptibility. What is the magnetic susceptibility? It is denoted by the letter chi, and this is equals to the amount of intensity of magnetization for unit field, magnetizing field intensity. Even since the intensity of magnetization is a vector quantity, even the magnetic susceptibility is also vector quantity. So chi will be equals to I divided by H. And what will be the unit for it? The intensity of magnetization and the magnetizing field intensity, both will have the same units. Both will have the same units. Therefore, they will be cancelled with each other. Hence, the magnetic susceptibility is a unitless as well as a dimensionless physical quantity, which will describe what is this magnetic susceptibility will describe us. It will describe us how far the specimen, how far the magnetizing material, the magnetic material could be magnetized. If its susceptibility is more, then it could accept or it can suspect. Then it can accept the more number of lines to pass through. That means it could able to behave like the perfect magnetic material. So magnetic susceptibility, if it is more, it could able to generate the more magnetic field, or in other words, it could able to magnetize more firmly or more strongly. So that is what called magnetic susceptibility, and it is a unitless as well as a dimensionless quantity. The next one is, magnetic susceptibility is over, the next one we need to understand is the magnetic permeability. Magnetic permeability, it is denoted by the letter mu, which is defined as B divided by H. Somewhere from the previous thing we have seen, so B H equals to B by mu, we have written the same thing. So just by rearranging, mu equals to B by H. The ratio of magnetic induction to magnetizing field intensity will be called as a magnetic permeability, and it will have the unit Henry per meter. It will have the unit called Henry per meter. Magnetic induction will be measured with the unit called Weber per meter square. Magnetizing field intensity is measured with the unit called Ampere per meter. Their ratio is nothing but Henry per meter. So this is nothing but magnetic permeability. What is the difference between susceptibility and permeability? Permeability will tell you how easily the material could be magnetized, and the susceptibility will tell you how strongly it got magnetized. That is a major difference. So permeability will tell you how much ease it could able to magnetize, and this will be nothing but how much strongly it got magnetized. So how much extent it got magnetized, that could be explained by magnetic susceptibility. How easily it can be magnetized, that will be explained by magnetic permeability. And now let us try to find out the relationship among all these quantities. Actually, the relationship could be found from very simple expression. What we know is
B equals to mu naught times of H plus I.
Actually, we know this relation. What is that? B naught equals to mu naught into H, as well as B equals to mu into H, where B naught is nothing but magnetic induction inside the assumed volume, and mu naught is nothing but magnetic permeability of free space, and B is nothing but magnetic induction that actually took place inside the specimen, and mu is nothing but that specimen's magnetic permeability, H are nothing but the magnetizing field intensity. The relationship among these two quantities is nothing but this one, B equals to mu naught times of H plus I. From here, can I note down like this, mu naught times of H multiplied by 1 plus I by H. This is nothing but what? Magnetic susceptibility. And so, can I note down like this one, B is nothing but mu into H. B equals to mu into H, the same expression I have taken here, and mu naught into H times of 1 plus chi. And now from here, H, H get cancelled out. What I am going to get? Mu equals to mu naught times of 1 plus chi. This is the relationship between the magnetic permeability of any material with the magnetic permeability of the free space, which will be linked with the help of the magnetic permeability. Magnetic susceptibility. Now from here, mu by mu naught, which is nothing but 1 plus chi, this will be also called as the relative permeability. The relative permeability. The relative permeability is equals to 1 plus chi. These are the relationship among different physical quantities. So far what we understood, which are related with the magnetic materials. Now, with this background, let us try to understand the classification of magnetic materials. The classification of magnetic materials. Let us know first the para. We will start with the diamagnetic materials. Diamagnetic materials. We will first understand what is the reason for diamagnetism. It was found that in this universe, every material will have a feeble diamagnetic property. And let us know what is the reason behind it. Usually, the materials which have a single electron, usually the materials which will have a paired electrons, they will exhibit the diamagnetic property. What is the reason behind that? So, since the paired electrons will revolve around the nucleus in opposite directions, the total magnetic moment will be always get cancelled out. So, in case of diamagnetic material, there will be no net magnetic moment. There will be no net magnetic moment that possessed by the both material as well as a atom. For an atom, there will be no net magnetic moment. For a material as a whole also, it will not possess any net magnetic moment. Now, these kind of materials, when you keep inside the external magnetic field, what will be happened is, the orbital motion of an electron will be modified such a way that there will be certain amount of magnetic moment that will be arises in the direction opposite to the external field. So, when the two electrons are moving in the opposite direction, then when this arrangement is kept inside the magnetic field, external magnetic field, then what will happen is the orbital motion of an electron will be get modified in such a way that there will be some net magnetic moment which will arises in the direction opposite to the external field. So that is the main reason behind the diamagnetism. So the main reason is nothing but the orbital motion will be modified. The orbital motion would get modified such a way that net moment will in opposite direction to external field. So that's why usually we will define the diamagnetic materials like this. The materials which will get a feeble magnetism in the direction opposite to the external field, that kind of materials will be called as a diamagnetic materials. So that feeble magnetism that will be arises due to the change of orbital motion, the modification of orbital motion of an electron. So diamagnetic materials are nothing but the materials which will develop a feeble magnetism in the direction opposite to the external field. So they will be called as in diamagnetic materials. What are the examples?
The example for diamagnetic materials is nothing but sodium chloride, water, hydrogen, bismuth, zinc. These are all examples for diamagnetic materials.
Now let us understand what are the properties of diamagnetic materials. What are the properties? The first property is nothing but whenever you keep the diamagnetic material inside the uniform magnetic field, then the magnetic lines of force will be slightly repelled. They will be repelled like this. If you keep inside the uniform magnetic field, then magnetic field lines are slightly repelled. Therefore, it will take a shape like this. When you suspend this diamagnetic material inside a strong uniform magnetic field, then this specimen will stood in a vertical direction. Whenever this specimen is suspended freely inside the strong uniform magnetic field, then what will happen due to these repulsion forces and all, this will turn such a way that it will stood inside the magnetic field. It will stand inside the magnetic field. This is the one of the property. And the next one is, whenever you have a U-tube and which is filled with the diamagnetic materials liquid, and let us suppose here I have a strong magnet, strong electromagnet that I kept in between the two faces of the limbs. And now when I turn on this electromagnet, then what will happen? The level of the liquid will be slightly depressed because of the repulsion force. It is offering to the external field, the level of the diamagnetic material liquid will be slightly depressed. And the fourth property. And what is the fourth property? These diamagnetic materials. For this, since the magnetic moment is the magnetic moment arising within them, they are in the opposite direction external field, this magnetic moment will be always negative. Therefore, the intensity of magnetization is also negative. And what about the chi? Chi is nothing but magnetic susceptibility. And this will be also negative, but it will be the small value. And finally, what will be the relative permeability? Relative permeability is nothing but 1 plus chi. So since it is a negative and that is also small, the chi will be less than 1, but it is positive. Chi will be equals to less than 1, but it is always positive. And one more interesting thing regarding this diamagnetic material is, for a diamagnetism, the magnetic susceptibility is always independent of temperature. So that we can draw here one small graph. What is that is? For diamagnetic materials. If I raise the temperature, then if I observe how the susceptibility is changing, then I could observe it is always constant. Why it is plotted in the downside of this graph? That is nothing but chi is always negative. That's why I have to draw here. So this is independent of temperature. The diamagnetism property is independent of temperature. And this diamagnetic property will be exhibited by the material as long as external field is turned on. Whenever the external field is turned off, then automatically these materials will lose their property also. So the diamagnetic property is a property which will be restored as long as the external field is there. When the external field is turned off, the diamagnetic property will be also just turned off. It will lose its diamagnetism property. That means that feeble repulsion property will be lost by material when the external field is off. And let us know about the next important material, that is paramagnetic material.
Let us know first what is the definition, and I will tell you the properties of paramagnetic materials. Paramagnetic materials. These are nothing but paramagnetic materials. These are the materials which will develop a feeble magnetism in the direction of external field, so that they would try to attract the external field into them. So the paramagnetic materials are nothing but the materials which will develop a feeble magnetism in the direction of external field, so that the magnetic lines of force will be attracted into them. What are the examples? The best example for paramagnetic materials are nothing but copper chloride, oxygen, aluminium and platinum. These are the examples for paramagnetic materials. Now let us know first what is the reason behind the paramagnetism. Paramagnetism reason. Let us know what is the reason behind it. So the simple reason is nothing but these are the materials which will have the zero magnetic moment. The net magnetic moment is always equals to zero. That means that every individual atom of paramagnetic materials will have a unpaired electron. That unpaired electron will constitute some magnetic moment for each of the atom. So in the material as a whole, the magnetic moment of individual atom magnets, since the every atom will have a certain amount of magnetic moment, those will be considered as the atomic magnets. And these all atomic magnets, magnetic moments will be aligned in different direction, such that the net magnetic moment will be equivalent to zero. That is what will happen generally for paramagnetic material when you don't keep inside the magnetic field. So if this is a paramagnetic material, let us say, then if this substance will have so many number of the atom magnets whose magnetic moments will be aligned in different direction, such that the total net magnetic moment will be zero. When you keep this kind of paramagnetic material inside the external field, then what would happen? The magnetic moments of individual atoms will be turned because of the external field such a way that they will all be aligned in the direction of external field. The magnetic moments of individual atom magnets will be turned because of the external field. They will experience some torque. Due to the torque, they will be rotated such a way that all the different alignments will have now in the direction of a magnetic field. Therefore, the total net magnetic moment will be arises in the direction of external field, so that they can attract the external field. This is the reason behind the paramagnetism. Okay, fine. And now let us see what are the properties of paramagnetic materials. What are the properties? The first one is, when you keep the paramagnetic material specimen inside the poles of a strong magnet, then immediately the poles will be generated in the opposite direction and the magnetic field lines will be sucked into this into this substance like this. If this is a uniform magnetic field which would be generated here, and certain number of lines will be sucked into the substance, that means they will be attracted into the substance. Therefore, the arrangement will be made like this. The arrangement of magnetic field lines of force will be appeared like this. And the next one, if you suspend one bar magnet which is paramagnetic in nature inside the magnetic field, external field, then it will be aligned in such a way that the poles will be opposite. If it is aligned in the direction, if it is suspended inside the uniform magnetic field like this, from north pole to south pole, then here we have a south pole, here I will have a north pole. And the third property is, we have understood about this one. If it is a U-tube which is containing the paramagnetic substance liquid, and if we keep one of the limb between the strong electromagnet and if we turn on it, then what will happen? The level of the liquid will be slightly move up. It will be raised. The level of the liquid will be raised. And the next one is, since the magnetic moment is in the direction of external field, the magnetic moment will be considered as a positive.
Then what will happen for intensity of magnetization?
Intensity of magnetization is also in the same direction, therefore it will be also positive. And what will be happen for susceptibility? The susceptibility is also positive, but it is not a big number, it is a small number, but since it is a positive. And the next one, relative permeability. Relative permeability is greater than 1, but since it is positive, still it is a positive only. And how it will depend upon the temperature. And the final classification of magnetic material, that is ferromagnetic material, that and all we will see in the next session. Thank you.